हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू? कैसे हैं आप लोग? राइट, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द माइक्रोवेव इंजीनियरिंग फॉर द स्पेसिफिक फॉर द इसरो, राइट, ईसी 2019-20. नाउ दैट इज द ब्रीफ आइडिया अबाउट मी. माय नेम इज चंदन झा, right? And M.Tech from Communication Network, conducted more than 200 sessions. You all are aware about this, right? So we are not going to discuss this. Now for the number of days left for the ISRO EC, right? That is 08, right? Only 8 days are left for the ISRO exam, right? Sumit Kumar, fine. That's great, dear. Now for the next. Okay, apart from the microwave, we are going to discuss one few things. In the life, you all are aware, ESC, that is called Engineering Services Examination, is going to be held on 5th of January, right? So we are going to analyze, the ESC paper, right? ESC paper for paper 1 and paper 2 for the all the branches, that is Electrical Engineering, Electronics and Telecommunication, Mechanical Engineering, and as well as for the Civil Engineering. For paper 1, that is the session will be on 5:30, and paper 2, the session will be at 8:30 p.m. right? And in this session we are going to discuss the answer key of all the questions, weightage analysis, and expected cutoff for that, right? Yes, Apurva is good evening, sir. I was eagerly waiting for this session. Keep the chashma if you have while teaching, sir. Oh, thank you, Apurva. Thank you, Sarab. Shubham, good evening, sir. Sir, material science ke video इसरो कब आएगा? आ जाएगा दोस्त, अभी चल रहा है उसका सेशन, राइट? नाउ फॉर द माइक्रोवेव जनरली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, बिकॉज आई हैव एनालिसिस द प्रीवियस ईयर पेपर ऑफ द इसरो एग्जाम, एंड आफ्टर दैट आई हैव थॉट द फ्यू टॉपिक इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द इसरो, राइट? वन और टू क्वेश्चन वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट इन द न्यूमेरिकल, एंड द रेस्ट अदर टॉपिक ऑफ द माइक्रोवेव वी जनरली डील विद अबाउट द थियोरटिकल क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू द माइक्रोवेव, राइट? नाउ द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट इज टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन. आफ्टर दैट रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन. रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन. आफ्टर दैट टीडब्ल्यूटी, दैट इज ट्रेवलिंग वेव ट्यूब, टीडब्ल्यूटी. एंड आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन न्यूमेरिकल ऑफ इसरो 2018 लास्ट ईयर पेपर एक्चुअली, राइट? दैट इज कॉल्ड कपलर एंड आइसोलेटर. दैट इज एक्चुअली डिफरेंट थिंग, बट इट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स फॉर द व्हाट? फॉर द माइक्रोवेव इंजीनियरिंग. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, एंड येस वील डू सम क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो विच इज द प्रीवियस ईयर इसरो क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू क्रिस्टॉन, रिफ्लेक्स, टीडब्ल्यूटी, कपलर एंड आइसोलेटर, right, regarding to this topic, right? It is the most important topic for what? For the micro. One topic also, that is magnetron. So if we'll have the time, then definitely we'll discuss the magnetron topic also, right? Suruchi, good evening. Samira, good evening. Medicine store, hello sir, hello. Akash, hello. Sheikh Firoz, good evening. Right, now okay, for the microwave tube, if first we'll discuss about the microwave tube. In the microwave tube, what is the principle? Principle behind the microwave tube is velocity modulation. Now, what is the velocity modulation? We'll discuss the velocity modulation in the next slide, right? What is the velocity modulation? So, first we are going to discuss about what? Two cavity klystron amplifier, right? It is nothing, it is just a microwave amplifier. What happened? It is the structure of the two cavity klystron amplifier. In this, there will be the one cathode and there will be the one anode. We can say that is the collector, right? And at the cathode, there will be the electron gun. It is nothing, it is just an electron gun. And electron gun is supplied to the negative terminal of the battery, right? Now, that is called anode. Now, there will be the two cavity. That's why the name here simplifies the two cavity. There will be the two cavity. One is called buncher cavity and another one is called catcher cavity, right? So there will be the two cavity. One is what is the buncher cavity, another one is the catcher cavity, and distance between these cavity are called drift space. is called the drift space. So just remember, there will be the two cavity. First is the buncher cavity, second one is the catcher cavity, and distance between these cavity are called what? The drift space. And when electron is emitted by the cathode, by the negative supply, when the electron is just like the electron is emitted by the cathode, and RF input is given to the buncher cavity, that is the microwave input, or we can say that sometime it is the RF input, right? The radio frequency input. So RF input is applied to this buncher cavity, and that output or amplified output is received at the microwave output at this terminal, at this terminal, right? Now what happened, how the signal is basically amplified? So when this electron is given, then let's suppose the microwave input or the RF input is like this. RF input is like this. So there will be the RF, I'm taking the sinusoidal RF signal, and the sinusoidal RF signal, there will be the two parts, right? One is the positive, another one is the negative, and some having the magnitude what? Zero. So the electron which is emitted by the cathode will face three type of process, or will face three type of phenomenon with when it contacted with the what? The RF wave or RF input into the buncher cavity. Name itself says it will bunch the electron. How the electron will be bunches? So I am saying there will be the three electrons, right? Just take, there are probably the three electrons. One is called early electrons. It is called early electron. Second one is called ER, that is called reference electron. Reference electron. And the next one is called EL, that is called late electron. So not all electrons are emitted simultaneously, right? Not all electrons are emitted simultaneously. There will be the three type of electron are emitted. I'm generally classified into three parts. The one is the early electron, second one is the reference electron, and the third one is the late electron. Reference electron, when comes in the contact of the what? The RF, when the electron bunch is contacted with the RF signal, then if that electron contact with this terminal at this point, then it will not accelerated, or it will neither accelerated nor retarded, it will move on the velocity, and that velocity is called reference velocity. So a reference electron will move with the velocity, we can say the reference velocity, right? Now what happened to the early electron? If the early electron will contacted with this positive part, then it will be accelerated, then it will be accelerated, and the velocity of that electron is called, or we can say, sorry, if this electron is comes in the contact of the negative part, and if this electron will contact in the negative part, then that electron velocity is called early electron velocity, right? V. And the late electron velocity, I'm saying VL, right? And one thing more, there will be the one terminology that everywhere in the microwave they are using, the one terminology that is called transit time. One numerical we can also solve from the transit time, right? What is transit time? So transient time is nothing, it is just a time required by the electron to move from buncher cavity to the catcher cavity, right? Or we can say that from cathode to anode is called what? Transient time. So I'm just writing the definition of the transient time. Time required by the electron to reach from cathode to anode is called what? Transient time. And as we know, it is a time. What is the formula of the time? Time formula is nothing, it is just a distance upon what? Velocity. So if you want to find out the time, then it is nothing, it is just a distance upon velocity. Now how to calculate the velocity? How we'll find out the velocity of that electron? So we'll discuss in the next slide how to will calculate the velocity of the electron. So now we are moving on the next, right? That is the formula how to calculate the velocity, that is velocity of the electron, right? How to calculate LS velocity? So for the velocity, what is the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy, nothing, it is just a half mv square. And the potential energy, nothing, it is just a Q V naught, right? V naught is a voltage. So if we want to find out the V is nothing, it is just a root of 2 Q V naught upon M. And we know that the charge of the Q electron is nothing, it is just a 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19, and mass is 9.1 into 10 raised to power minus 30. So if you'll put this value here, you'll get the exact formula. That is called 0.593 into 10 raised to power 6 root of V naught. That is the simplified form, right? Just remember this one. To find out what? To find out the velocity of electron when it moves from cathode to anode. And if the velocity is calculated, how will we find out the time or transit time? transit time is nothing, it is just a distance upon velocity. We have calculated the velocity by this formula. And what is the distance? Let the distance between these two things are d. So I'm writing d upon v naught. It is a transit time. And there will be the one numerical of ISRO also on this formula. Right? Right. Now, we'll move on the next. Right? That is the electron, right? Now, what happened in this? We have seen there will be the three electrons, reference electron. So reference electron is contacted in this position. One is the late electron and the early electron. So I am saying that the electron which comes on the contact of this will be accelerated, or speed of that electron will increase. And an electron which comes in the contact of the negative part or negative maximum value of the RF signal will be retarded. And if it will be the retarded, then obvious the velocity is what changes. So the electron velocity will change according to the RF signal, and this is called what? Velocity modulation. Velocity modulation is nothing, it is just what? The velocity of the electron will change with respect to what? With respect to the amplitude of what? RF signal. So here, whatever we are doing, we are changing the velocity of the electron with respect to what? With respect to RF signal or amplitude of the RF signal, right? So it is taking the time, yes. Now we are moving on the next part. Yes, one thing more. For the klystron, two cavity klystron, just remember efficiency formula. If we want to find out the efficiency, I am just giving the quick revision for this. That is the very, very useful for the microwave, right? You know the microwave syllabus is very vast. But I am taking only the few topic which is very, very important for the ISRO, right? So for the efficiency, what is the formula for the efficiency? Efficiency, nothing, it is just output power upon DC power. Output power upon DC power is called efficiency. And if you want to find out the efficiency of two cavity klystron, the maximum efficiency of the two cavity klystron is nothing, it is just what? 58%, 58% sirf kya rahegi iski maximum efficiency. Just make a note for this. Right? Now, that is the basically what? That is the two cavity klystron. Right? So in the two cavity klystron, one thing what? One thing is the formula related. Just remember few things. Again, I am repeating. First, how to calculate the velocity. Second one, how to find out the transit time. What is the transit time? What is the basic principle of cavity klystron? And how the signal is amplified? And the second one, for regarding to this, the efficiency, maximum efficiency will be nothing. It is just a 58%, right? For the numerical, we can expect this type of question, right? Now, if we are moving on the next, that is called reflex klystron, right? Reflex klystron. So what happened in the reflex klystron? There will be the only one, or we can say that there will be the one cavity is used, right? This cavity, right? And there is the one electron gun, which is basically, transmitting the electron beam, which is transmitted the electron beam. And there will be the one cathode, or we can say that it is nothing, it is just a repeller electrode. What repeller electrode is basically attached with the negative terminal of the battery. And if electron will move from this portion, and as you know, the electron having the negative charge. So it will move that electron into the right hand side toward the repeller electrode, then it will be reflected back. It will be reflected back, right? Because electron also has the negative charge and the repeller also has the negative side. So negative, negative, both when can repel, and electron again transmit into what? Again move into the this part, that is the at the side of the anode. And this distance is called repeller space. This distance is called repeller space. So what happened actually? How the signal is amplified in this portion? In this portion, the signal, because two cavity klystron is very, very typical to analyze in the practical lab. That's why the reflex klystron is used, because only one cavity is sufficient to amplify the signal. What happened? If there will be the signal again, there will be the three types of electron. One is the early electron, second one is the reference electron, third one is the late electron. So electron will repel back, and it will be splitted into three, and this will be accumulated at this point, and they will form the bunch. They will form the what? Bunch. That's why the electron bunching will take place, right? Because if electron, there will be the three electrons, one moving the fast, another one moving the slow, and the third one is the moving with the reference point. So at the particular instant, then three electrons get together, and there will be the, you know what, they will be joined together, and this is called electron bunching actually, right? Now, So the deflect klystron is a single cavity klystron that overcome the disadvantage of what? Two cavity klystron oscillator, right? Now what happened in this? So I am saying there is a three type of electron. One is the early electron. If early electron is moving, then it will comes in the contact of what? It will comes on the contact of the positive RF signal. So if it comes in the contact of the positive RF signal, then it will be accelerated, or speed of the electron will increase. So if the speed of the electron will increase, so I am writing the early electron having the maximum speed as compared to the reference electron, right? Now, reference electrons will come on the contact of this. So it will moving with the, its natural speed, right? Vr equal to V naught. And there will be the late electron. I am writing there will be the late electron. Late electron, it means it will comes later to the reference electron. It will moving with the slower speed. So it's it having the distance is so it having the slower speed, it having the reference speed, and it having the higher speed. So at the particular distance, both electron or all the electrons will get together, and it will form what? It will form bunch. And if you find out the distance between these bunch from the reference, then it will called total, right? Right, the second reference. So, and this distance is nothing, it is just what called 3/4. It is called 3/4, right? So everywhere, if you are writing, so it is called 3/4. Just remember this one, because mode is basically defined like this, N plus, or I'm writing mode next in the slide. I'm writing the mode, what is the mode of the klystron, because we can expect the question related to mode also, right? And yes, definitely, we'll do some question related to the ISRO exam, jo 2018 mein bhi aaye hain, 2017 mein bhi aaye hain, 2016 mein bhi aaye hain, and you will see that question is very easy. By the basic concept or basic formula, we can solve everything, right? Now, yes, few formula we should remember always about the reflex klystron. What is the formula? The first one is the what? I'm writing next. First one, the operating frequency. First one is the operating frequency for the reflex klystron. So the operating frequency of the reflex klystron, nothing, it is just a 4 gigahertz to 200 gigahertz. So it is the wide range of the frequency, right? Bandwidth is high. Second one, output power. The maximum output power of the reflex klystron is nothing, it is just a 3 watt. 3 watt is the maximum output power. And maximum theoretical efficiency, if you want to find out, then the theoretical efficiency is nothing, it is just a 22.7% for what? For 1 3/4 mode, right? So how we'll get the mode? So mode, we can write like this, right? The formula of the mode is nothing, we can write the formula mode also, but just write down this one, right? So there will be the minimum mode of the electron is nothing, it is just a n plus 3/4 actually the mode. So if we want to write, or n into 3/4, so for the first, for n equal to 0, the first mode of operation is 3/4. The second mode of operation is 1 into 3/4, 1 3/4. N equal to 2 having the 2 3/4. That is the mode of operation, right? So everywhere for the reflex klystron, if they are using the mode 3/4, and this 3/4 is comes due to this point, this 3/4. Due to this 3/4, every time they are using what? The 3/4, right? And this value I'm using n. This value I am saying n, right? Generally, for the reflex klystron, generally using, these two are widely used. Widely used. Now, there will be the tuning. So, for the reflex klystron, there will be, what is the tuning? If we want to change the frequency, then how we can change the frequency? So, there will be the two types of tuning for the reflex klystron is possible. One is called mechanical tuning, and the second one is called electronic tuning. One is called mechanical tuning, another one is called electronic tuning. So mechanical tuning is done by the screw, and electronic tuning is done by the what? By the RF signals, by the voltage, right? By the voltage, we can change the electronic tuning, frequency will change. And mechanical tuning, by the screw, we can change the what? Mechanical, it is the mechanical tuning. And now, if you want to find out the mode, we have already written what is the mode, right? Now, so mode n is nothing, it is just I am writing n plus 3/4 is actually the formula for the mode, right? One thing more, so just remember one thing, for E electronic, if we want to write ETS, right, that is called ETS, electronic, right, ETS, electronic tuning sensitivity, जब भी कभी दोस्त ध्यान रखना प्रॉब्लम में, जब भी कभी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ट्यूनिंग सेंसिटिविटी पूछ लिया जाए, व्हेनेवर दे आर आस्किंग द ईटीएस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक, तो जस्ट रिमेंबर द वन फॉर्मूला, ईटीएस इक्वल टू एफ टू माइनस एफ वन अपॉन वी टू माइनस वी वन, यूज दिस फॉर्मूला, राइट, एफ टू माइनस एफ वन अपॉन वी टू माइनस वी वन, व्हाट इज एफ टू, एफ टू इज द 3 dB, एफ टू एंड एफ वन इज द 3 dB कट ऑफ और हाफ पावर frequency. It is called half power frequency. It is half power frequency. It is the voltage respect to half power bandwidth, half power frequency of F2. It is the voltage with respect to half power frequency of voltage of F1, right? So just remember this formula. So I'm writing, there will be the mode. You all are aware about the mode. You just remember this formula of ETS, electronic tuning sensitivity. Use this formula, F2 minus F1 upon V2 minus V1. And how to find out the mode, right? And one by the one numerical. By the one numerical, we can solve every question related to that, right? Sir, what is the weightage of this part? Dost, isi part ka sabse jyada weightage hai. Ajuppa, the most important part is the basically the reflex klystron and the TWT and the klystron, two cavity klystron having the more important part. Sir, wo formula thoda upar likh sakte hain. Bilkul kyun nahi likh sakte hain? Bilkul likh sakte hain. Fir se likh deta hun. For the electronics, right? Tuning sensitivity is nothing, it is just a F2 minus F1 upon V2 minus V1, right? Generally, we are using F in gigahertz, so the unit will be gigahertz per volt. Unit will be gigahertz per volt, right? Now, so we'll solve some question related to this also, right? And if we want to find out the mode M, so we'll solve this one by the numerical. We can use one formula also. In the numerical, we'll solve it. Sir, aapne ka FFT wala part baki hai. Eagerly waiting for that. Definitely, we'll solve that thing also. Sir, formula for the transit time. Apurva, I have already written the formula for the transit time, right? Now, and we'll solve one question related to transit time also. So don't worry, Apurv. We'll solve one question related to transit time also, right? That is the 2018. And one coupler, from the coupler we can explain the theoretical portion also. Right now, the next one is the traveling, next one is called the traveling wave tube, TWT. In the TWT, there will be the, that portion is called helix. This, okay, that portion is called helix. This portion is called helix. So in this portion, in the TWT, electron which is emitted by the cathode is comes in the contact of what, this helical path, and again there will be the velocity modulation take place. Again there will be the same principle will repeated it there also. There will be the three electron, early electron, reference electron and the late electron, and when then electron will move from this part, then definitely the some electrons. So I'm writing, I'm explaining this portion, what happened in the helix, that is the helix, right? So electron will moving like this, it is the electron. It is the RF signal which is applied, right? So in the starting, electron position is like this. So when electron will moves, they will comes closer, again they will comes closer, and the last, and at the last electrons will bunch together. And after the bunching, it will supply or it will provide the energy, or it will transfer that energy to the what? It will transfer that energy to the RF signal, or RF signal will be amplified, right? Or microwave signal, or microwave signal will be amplified for this, right? So we are nothing. In this principle, we are doing only one thing. We are bunching the electron and transferring that energy to the signal, right? Because we know that the principle of the conservation of the energy, energy never be created nor destroyed. So when it comes into the contact of what, RF, it will transfer the energy. So there will be the what, physical structure of what, TWT. Now if we are moving and the collector will collect what, the electron beam, again that will be the collected at the collector, that is the traveling wave tube, TWT. Few points regarding to TWT you should remember. The one point is nothing, the first, V naught equal to Vp, right? V naught equal to Vp. The interaction take place between there in the such a way that on an average electron beam deliver energy to the RF wave. Electron beam again delivering the what? Energy to the RF signal. When the axial electron field is zero, when the axial electron field is zero, it means if the RF signal, if the field is zero like this at this point, then though there is no acceleration as well as the retardation, right? So when axial electron field is zero, electron velocity unaffected. When axial electric field is positive, then the electron will be accelerated with the high velocity. And when it will comes on the negative part, then it will what? Retarded, and the speed of the velocity, speed of the electron will reduce. Now, when the axial electric field is positive, that yes. Now, velocity of the electron, these electrons are called early electron, right? So, if the electron is moving with a higher speed is called the early electron. Electron which is moving with the slower speed is called the late electron, right? Bunched together. The electron in the branch, in the counter, right, in the counter retarded field, so it will deliver the energy to the wave on the helix. Helix, it will contact it with the what? RF signal, and it will transfer the energy. Yes, one formula you should remember, right? Helix successive cycle energy goes and increase, right? Yes, that is called phase velocity. Just remember this formula. That is the formula of phase velocity. So this is the formula of phase velocity. P is nothing, it is just a pitch. P is the pitch. What is the pitch? So for the helix, it is looking like this. So this distance is called P, that is called pitch. Pitch. And D is called dia of helix. It is called the dia of helix. So by this we can find out what the phase velocity. Just remember this formula, right? P upon root of mu naught. We know our, what is the mu naught. Mu naught is nothing. It is just a what? Mu naught, E naught. You all are aware about mu naught, epsilon r. We also deal this thing in the material science. P is nothing. It is just a pitch. Pi 3.14. D is nothing. It is just a dia of helix. Yes, there will be the one question. Sir, what is the use of the helix? Helix is called slow, right? To process, because the electron are moving and it will moves into the helix, then it will comes in the more time with the contact of what? With the contact of RF signal. So if it will comes in the most of the time, or there will be the lots of time at which the RF signal is contacted with the electron bunch, then definitely the energy transfer rate is high. That is the most, that's why it is called slow, right? With the successive speed, energy goes and increase, right? And yes, the operating principle is nothing, it is just a 300 hertz to 500. Just write down the for this important point. Just write down this one. TWT is capable of the high bandwidth, the second one. Low frequency, the gain limited to the helix length, right? That is the important regarding to what? Regarding to the TWT. Second, first, just forget about this point. Just remember second point. At low frequency, the gain is limited by helix length. Second one, TWT is capable of high bandwidth, right? Enormous high bandwidth. It is main application as the medium or higher power amplifier, right? Either continuous wave or the pulse wave. The initial velocity of the electron is slightly greater than that of the axial RF field. The extra initial velocity of the electron beam is balanced to retardation due to the energy being given to the RF band. Everywhere the principle is basically same. How the electron gets the energy, right? And after that electron gain the energy, it will bunch together, and after that it will transfer that energy to the signal, and so that the signal will be amplified. Now the TWT are capable of much higher duty cycle, right? Just remember about duty cycle, right? One theoretical question in the ISRO 2016 will be asked regarding to this. We'll solve this question in the class. TWT are capable of much higher duty cycle than klystron or the magnetron, right? Thus application of the feature required, right? Now the TWT operates under the following parameter beam. V naught is 3 kilovolt, I naught is 30 milliampere. It is not that much of important data, so you can skip this data. So the most important point is second, third, fourth, fifth, and obvious that is the sixth, right? These points are very, very important. You should remember this, right? Sir, what is the benefit of the klystron over TWT? In the TWT, there is no need of the, first of all, just remember one thing. in the TWT crystalline, in the TWT, there will be the what? There will be the no cavity required. But yes, in the klystron, there will be the cavity required. So just remember this one, right? D, sir, dia means diameter. Yes, P Ramaya, dia means diameter, right? Now, for the next, we are solving some question related to this, right? Just solve this question. Everybody just solve this question. It is the question related to transit time. I have already said ki we will do some question related to transit time also, right? Yes, just solve this question. I am reading this question for you. A reflex klystron is oscillating at 10 gigahertz when operated in 2 3/4 modes. We all are aware. What is the 2 3/4? If mode is written 2 3/4, then we can say that it is nothing. It is just a N, right? It is a N modes. Find the transit time of the electron in repelled space in nanosecond, right? We have to find out. Just solve this question. Just solve this question, everybody. Here, just remember one thing for the transit time formula for reflex klystron, right? For reflex klystron, just use this formula. Transit time tau equal to N plus whatever they given in the problem, N plus 3/4. That is nothing. It is just a mode, right? It is a mode upon F. Right? Just use this formula to find out what transit time. This is given in the problem. Actually, it is nothing. It is just a mode upon F, right? N upon F. It is transit time formula. N upon F. And N is nothing. N plus 3/4. We all are aware. So I can write N plus 3/4 upon F is the formula. So if you'll find out the transit time, right? Will yes, yes, yes. Question will answer will be given by the Kirti Singh. Correct. Nanda Kumar, correct. Everybody just solve this question. It is now the formula based question. I am just giving this question only for this formula to you, right? So N value is nothing. What is the value of N? N value is 2. So I am writing 2 plus 3/4 divided by F. F is nothing. It is just a 10 raised to power gigahertz. So I am writing 10 raised to power 10. So it will become what? 11/4 into 10 raised to power minus 10. And in the nanosecond, so 11/4. So just write down, I'm just writing here directly 0.275 nanosecond. Yes, answer will be given. Divya is giving, Smriti, Prashant, Anita, Shubham, bahut badhiya. The answer will be what? B. That is a tough question or easy question, right? Just give me the answer for this. It is a tough question or easy question? Uday, correct. So just remember this formula for the transit time. It is very useful. And the one formula we all are aware, distance upon velocity, right? So there will be the two formula for the transit time. One, the distance upon velocity, and the second one is by the mode. By the mode, you will get like this. Right now, for the next, just solve this question. A four-port directional coupler has 4:1 power splitting ratio and has dissipated loss 3 dB. The coupler directivity, it is nothing, it is just a ISRO 2000 last year paper 2018. It is a ISRO 2018 question actually. So 4-port directional coupler had 4:1 power splitting ratio and has dissipation loss 3 dB. The coupler directivity is 40 dB. What fraction of the input power P1 will go to the part P2 and P3? What is the portion of the P1 goes at the port of P2 and P3? We have to find out. Just give me the answer for this. Everybody, just give me the answer for this. Okay, before going to this question, I'll give you some brief idea about the directional coupler, right? Directional coupler. I'll just give you the brief idea about the directional coupler. Just remember one thing. Oh. Directional coupler. I'm just giving you a brief idea about the directional coupler. What happened in the directional coupler? There will be the four port I'm writing in the directional coupler. I'm writing as a P1, P2, or P, I'm writing P, not P1. I'm writing this one as a PI input, PB, right, back power. It is P for forward here, and it is called what? Nothing, it is just a P received, PR. And the signal will moves from this. Or it will be reflect, it will be like this, in the reflected, like this, right? So there will be the three, right? So PI, that is the input power, is splitted into two parts. One is the received power, another one is the forward. It is here, PI is the input power, right? PI is the input power. PR is the received power. PR is the received power. PB is the back power. And PF is the forward power. And there will be some terms you should remember. Yeah, you should remember. What is the terms you should remember? The first one is the coupling factor. You should remember coupling factor. Coupling factor. Or sometimes it is also known as coupling coefficient. Coupling coefficient. Right? So if we want to find out the coupling coefficient for this, then it is nothing, it is just a C divided by, or C equal to, I am writing this coupling factor as a C. So C will be nothing, it is just a what? PF, for the this one, PI upon PF, right? PI upon PF. PI upon PF, this is called coupling factor, right? So we are writing like, if everything is written in the, always in the dB. So if always thing is written in the form of the dV, then we can say that C equal to 10 log PI upon PF. PI upon PF, just remember this one. Yes, Rajat Jain, sir, have you prepared that communication formula notes? Yes, Rajat, I have already given that thing to our support person, and definitely I think they will provide you. They have already provided that, that is the formula for the communication, right? That is related to MRA, right? Rajat, are you asking about the MRA, na? MRA signaling. Okay, so just remember one thing, that is the coupling factor. Second one, for the, after the coupling factor, the second one is the directivity. Directivity. I am writing the directivity as a D, right? Directivity. So if you want to find out the directivity D, then what is the formula or what is the directivity? PF upon PB. This ratio is called the directivity. PF upon PB is called directivity. And everything should be written in the form of what? In the dB. So everything should be written in the dB, then we can say that it is in dB 10 log PF upon PB. And third one, you should remember the third one also, that is called isolation factor. Third one is called isolation factor. I'm denoting the isolation factor as a I. And I is nothing, it is just a what? C plus D, in dB actually. C plus D is called isolation factor. Or generally we can say that the isolation factor PI by PB. PI by PB. PI by PB. I'm again writing here. PI by PB. So just use this one. Coupling factor, directivity and isolation. They will always ask the question related to this topic only, right? This topic only. Now, for the directional coupler, what given, okay, in the previous question, they will given what? The directivity. So PF by PB is given in the problem. PF by PV, or we can say that 10 log PF by PV directly is the given in the problem, right? So I'm writing, just now solve this question, right? It is whatever we are saying, PI is P1, PB is P4 here, and this one, P2 is actually PR, and P3 is nothing, it is just a what? P F. So just find out. For this one, just solve this question. Everybody. Sir, can we say coupling equal to isolation plus directivity? No. We cannot say this one. Isolation plus directivity. Actually, the isolation, we can say that the coupling plus directivity, right? Isolation, we can say that isolation equal to coupling plus directivity. Yes, we can say that. But we cannot say that a coupling equal to isolation plus directivity. Nanda, are you getting the point? Okay, if you want to solve this question, first of all, just remember what given in the problem. The dissipation loss 3 dB is given, right? So if the 3 dB loss is given, okay, just solve this question now. Everybody, just solve this question. Very easy. Not that much of tough question actually. Nobody solving this question, nobody responding for this question. It is a very basic question. Okay, now if you want to solve this question, what given the problem is, it is a coupler given, P1, P2, P3 and P4 is given actually in the problem. P3 and this is P4 is given in the problem. So power splitting ratio is what? Given the problem, power splitting ratio. It is 1 by 4, right? Power splitting four ratio is given what? 1 by 4, right? Or 4 is to 1, I think. 4 by 1, right? 4 is to 1, I'm writing. Or 1 by 4, 4 is to 1 writing. 4 is to 1, it is given in the problem. Now it is an aptitude-based question. It is not that much of tough question, right? Yes. Sumit is giving the answer A, Aparna is giving the answer C, Anuruddha is giving the answer C. Everybody just solve this question. That is not tough, typical question. It is very easy question actually. Okay, 3 dB, what do you mean by 3 dB? 3 dB means half power. 3 dB means what? Half power. Half power means if P1, then for the 3 dB, P1 is nothing. It is just a 1 by 2 P1, right? 3 dB means. Directivity is given in the problem. What is directivity? 40. And you all know what is the directivity formula. So for the directivity, PF upon PB, this upon this is given. This upon this is given. P3 by P4. So they are giving they are giving P3 by P4. So they are given P3 by P4 in dB. So I'm writing 10 log P3 by P4, directivity is given equal to what? 40 dB. So if you write directly P3 by P4, then we can say that it is nothing, 10 raised to power 4, right? I can directly write 10 raised to power 4. It is given in the problem, right? Now, if we want to write out what, if we want to find out what P3 in the terms of what? In the terms of P1. So P3 is nothing, it is just a 10 raised to power 4 into P4. It is the formula actually, right? Just solve, everybody just solve this question. Now that is the hint, very easy question. Okay, just forget about this. By this approach, we can directly solve this question. P3 by P4 is given, right? Now P3 is nothing. If we want to find out P3, P3 is what? Half P1, right? Half into P1 into. Because 3 dB, so we have to use what? Half P1 everywhere. And what is the coupling ratio? Coupling factor is given 4 is to 1. Coupling factor is given 4 is to 1. It means P2 by P3 is given. P2 by P3 is given, that is 1 by 4. P2 by P3 is given, that is 1 by 4. It is given in the problem. So the total, if 1%, 1 is for the P2, so I'm writing just like this. 1 upon, what is the total 1 plus 4? That is 5. It is nothing, it is just an aptitude question. So it will be what? 0.1 P1. So it will be 0.1 P1. Yes. screen because grade up is written in the bottom. Oh, sorry. Again, I'm writing. Sorry for that. Okay, what happened in the problem? I'm just writing. So P3 equal to nothing. It is just a half P1 because 3 dB power is given into what is that coupling factor? 1 out of the 5, right? So if there will be the 5 part, then one part will be only transferred. So it will be what? 0.1 P1. That is the P3. Right? Now what happened? Now we have to use, after the P3 we have to use, P3 we have calculated. Now we have to use what? Find out P2. So P2, if we want to find out P2, then P2 is nothing again what? 1 by 2 into P1. And what is the ratio? 4 upon 5. 4 part is for the P2. So it will be 4 by 10 P1, or we can say that 0.4 P1. So we have calculated P2 equal to 0.4 P1. It is basically the aptitude based question. And P3 equal to 0.1 P1. Right? Coupling diya hua hai. 5 part hai. 5 mein se 4 part ek pe ja raha hai, ek part ek mein ja raha hai. Aur 3 dB ye batata hai ki half power hi jayega. Right? So we can use what? What is the formula? P1. Answer will be what? P2 0.4 P1. Okay, so answer will be A. Right, answer will be A. A is Suraj correct. Apurva correct. Right. Now, Akash is asking, sir, microwave kya hota hai? In the spectrum band, if you will see, by the frequency, they are splitted into different part, right? Microwave, ultraviolet, violet, right? Visible range. That is the one frequency range is the microwave. And micro is not a basically the frequency. Frequency in the gigahertz, right? The micro is the basically the wavelength, right? Generally in the wavelength. Now we are moving on the next. Okay, that is the question. That is actually ISRO 2018 question, right? What is the exact, Samina is asking, what is the exact meaning of the coupling? Okay, coupling, exact meaning, if you want to find out the exact meaning of the coupling, then I am transferring the signal or power PI and it should be received at the PR, right? So if there will be the coupling loss, if there is not perfect matched, then some part will be lost. So it will not, PR is not equal to P1. So due to the insignificant coupling, or we can say that not proper coupling, the sum power will be lost, right? So coupling means the one is perfect matched with the other, right? Now we are moving on the next. Okay, just solve this question. It is also very easy question, theoretical question. It is also ISRO question, right? So in the ISRO, they have two type of question. One is the numerical question, another one is the theoretical question, and the most of the question is basically the theoretical part. So the second one, the modes in the reflex klystron. Just solve this question. Modes of the reflex klystron. Just give me the answer for this. Different oscillating frequency of the cavity. No. Yes, everybody, just give me the answer for this. Prashant, I think D, sir. Yes. The answer will be correct, D. Actually, for the reflex klystron, what is the first option? The result from excessive oscillating frequency of the cavity. No, that is not possible in this. That is not excessive frequency cavity. Respond to the different oscillating frequency of the cavity. No, it is also not. Because reflex klystron, if we want to, then voltage level we have to change. Are caused by this scoring frequency modulation. That is not frequency modulation. The last one, the all gives much the same frequency but different. Yes, the frequency will be same, but yes, the transit time will be different because all electrons will appear or moves with a different velocity, right? Now, for the next, so D option is correct. Yes, Hare Krishna, correct. Now, just give me this answer of this question. The cavity magnetron, actually it is magnetron, we have didn't studied about the magnetron, but that is the theoretical question, that's why we can solve this question. The cavity magnetron uses trapping two, right? To avoid, there will be the one, yes. Sir, maths ka skip kar sakte hain kya ISRO ke liye? Prashant yaar, dekho dost, मैथ्स का क्वेश्चन जो है ना, अपने इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स की अगर मैं बात करूँ, स्पेशली फॉर द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, मैथ्स के 3 या 4 क्वेश्चन से ज़्यादा नहीं आते हैं। और अगर आपने गेट के लिए प्रिपेयर किया ना, तो मेरे ख्याल से इसरो का क्वेश्चन मैथ्स के लिए स्पेशली ईजी होता है, देन डेफिनेटली यू विल अटेम्प्ट इट। ओके, दैट्स ग्रेट। नाउ द कैविटी मैग्नेट्रॉन, देर विल बी द वन मोड इन द मैग्नेट्रॉन, देर विल बी लाइक दिस। ओके, लाइक दिस। सो देर विल बी द मोड। सो टू अवॉइड मोड जंपिंग, टू प्रिवेंट दिस, स्ट्रैपिंग इज यूजिंग, राइट? टू अवॉइड वॉट? टू अवॉइड मोड जंपिंग। सो द आंसर विल बी ए। सो द आंसर विल बी वॉट? ए, प्रिवेंट मोड जंपिंग। We have already give that question in the test series, our test series, right? Mega Mock Challenge. We have already given that question to you. Okay, now for the next. Just solve this question. The TWT is, it is the property based, right? We have given the 5 property, right? 5 or 6 property related to TWT. That is the key point. The one of the key point is sufficient to define this. Just give me the answer for this. Everybody, just respond for this. Yes, Apurva, larger duty cycle. Yes, yes, yes. Radar class tomorrow. Tomorrow the class will be of the radar, right? Radar ka class hoga dost, and the radar will discuss a question related to ISRO. Radar ko main ISRO ke question se hi rate karunga. Question hi lenge aur question se hi theory ko samajhne ki koshish karenge in the next class tomorrow. Tomorrow, not tomorrow, that is Monday. Not tomorrow, Saturday, Sunday is off. In the Monday, we'll discuss about the radar class, right? Not see how we can say that, see, broader broadband is not, yes, but the most important thing is capable of larger duty cycle. We have already mentioned this one. The most important benefit is to capable of the larger duty cycle. So the option will be A. Theoretical question, very easy question. Okay, just give me the answer of this question. One of the reason why conventional vacuum valve tube not used as a microwave frequency is that dear. वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, कॉमन सेंस लगाओगे तो भी हो जाएगा, थोड़ा सा कॉमन सेंस यूज करिए, राइट? यस समीरा, शंट कैपेसिटी इज लेस, यस दैट विल बी द करेक्ट, बट दैट इज नॉट एग्जैक्ट अप्रोच फॉर दिस। द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर दिस इज नॉइस इंक्रीजेस। ए, वन ऑफ द रीजन व्हाई कन्वेंशन, बिकॉज इन द If the vacuum coil is used and the microwave frequency, the noise definitely the introduced in the system and the degradation or performance degraded, right? Yes, option A is correct. Prashant, not B, A option though. Yes, yes, Apurva, correct, correct, correct. Ab dekho, ek ISRO ke liye ek aur key point deta hun aapko. For the ISRO specifically, ek cheez ka hamesha dhyan rakhiyega, is baar jo aap attempt karenge paper, in that just field one thing important, that is very, very important. Do not attempt all the questions. राइट, हमेशा एक चीज का ध्यान रखिए, ऐसा नहीं कि फर्स्ट डे आया, पहला क्वेश्चन आया, हमने सॉल्व किया, आफ्टर दैट हम सेकेंड ही क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करेंगे, आफ्टर दैट विल थर्ड क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज देर विल द ओनली 80 और वी कैन से दैट 2 आवर्स ना, राइट? 2 आवर्स फॉर द 80 क्वेश्चन, राइट? सो दिस इज वेरी टिपिकल टू सॉल्व दिस टाइप ऑफ अप्रोच, जिस तरीके से आप करते हो। तो आपको करना क्या है, क्वेश्चन को एक लाइन पढ़िए, पूरा क्वेश्चन पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं, एक लाइन पढ़िए, सिर्फ वन सेंटेंस। If you are capable of solving that question, or if you want to solve that question by reading only one attempt, आपको लगता है कि बहुत easy है, आप एक ही बार में पढ़ सकते हो। First question हमेशा किसी भी question के first statement से पता चल जाता है। For example, this one of the reason why conventional vacuum, if the conventional vacuum tube is given and I am not aware of the conventional vacuum tube, I can skip that question, right? किसी भी question को उठाइए, पिछला question देखिए, TWT नाम आया, TWT अगर आप फैमिलियर हैं, 90 मिनट्स, यस डेफिनेटली 90 मिनट्स, दैट इज वन एंड हाफ आवर, यस वन एंड हाफ आवर, सॉरी 90 नॉट 2 आवर्स, 90 मिनट्स फॉर 80 क्वेश्चन। सो अगर मैंने इस क्वेश्चन को पढ़ा और मैंने पूरा नहीं पढ़ूंगा, टाइम पास नहीं करूंगा, उसके अंदर आपके पास इतना टाइम नहीं मिलेगा कि आप टाइम पास करो। द टी डब्ल्यू टी इज द सम टाइम प्रीफर्ड टू द मैग्नेट, जनरली हम करते क्या है मैं वो बता रहा हूं। सर, टी डब्ल्यू टी इज द सम टाइम प्रीफर्ड टू द मैग्नेट्रॉन एज ए राडार ट्रांसमीटर आउटपुट ट्यूब बिकॉज इट इज capable of larger duty cycle, more efficient amplification, more broadband, less noisy। अरे नहीं आता यार, अब आगे बढ़ रहे हैं, आपने अननेसेसरी टाइम वेस्ट कर दिया। आपको क्या करना, TWT सर फैमिलियर नहीं है, स्किप कर दीजिए. सर फैमिलियर हूँ, पढ़िए. समटाइम क्या फिर विफर्ड किससे रिलेट किया, मैग्नेट्रॉन. दो पॉइंट से आपको समझ में आ जाएगा कि आपको क्या चीज़ है. अगले क्वेश्चन, किसी भी क्वेश्चन में देखिए एक लाइन सफिशियंट होता है. द कैविटी मैग्नेट्रॉन, मैग्नेट्रॉन आ गया. फैमिलियर है पूरा पढ़ूंगा, नहीं फैमिलियर है छोड़ के आगे बढ़ जाऊंगा. तो हमेशा टाइम मैनेजमेंट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर द इसरो. राइट राइट, सबसे मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट है दैट इज द टाइम मैनेजमेंट फॉर द इसरो. राइट ओके, दैट इज द फ्यू क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू दैट इज द फ्यू क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू वॉट दैट इज कॉल्ड माइक्रोवेव. माइक्रोवेव हमेशा फिर से मैं बता देता हूँ, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज द ट्रांजिट टाइम, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द ट्रांजिट टाइम, द बेसिक नॉलेज ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन, टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन, एंड वन टॉपिक आई हैव ऑलरेडी स्क्रिप्टेड दैट इज द मैग्नेट्रॉन. इफ देर विल द टाइम आई विल डेफिनेटली कवर दैट मैग्नेट्रॉन ऑल्सो. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू कवर एंटायर थ्योरी पोर्शन बिकॉज द वन आवर इज नॉट सफिशियंट टू डिस्क्राइब ओनली इन द रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन. इट विल टेक मोर देन वन आवर. रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन इटसेल्फ टेक अराउंड 2 to 3 आवर्स. सो फॉर द शॉर्ट अप्रोच और फॉर द इसरो स्पेसिफिक, यू शुड रिमेंबर द की पॉइंट्स and the exact formula for that, and exact formula for the how to calculate the mode. Second one is the I have already ETS, electronic sensitivity, and the third one is what transit time. So this type of question we can expect from the ISRO, and one is related to the coupler, right? That is also important. One thing also, that is T, ET, H, and magic T. You should study this one also. Right, T is also important, isolator is also important for this ISRO, right? That is the green card. The rate of the 12-month charges for the green card is 499, or for the 1 month, 299. And after the buying this green card, you can access every type of test series related to a technical, right? Okay, dear, thank you very much. And any doubt, if you have any doubt, देखिए मैं एक चीज़ और कर सकता था, पता है मैं पूरा रिफ्लेक्स, मैं ऐसा भी कर सकता था, रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन उठाया और पूरे रिफ्लेक्स क्लिस्ट्रॉन को मैंने पूरा पढ़ाना शुरू कर दिया. पर मुझे पता है कि वो पढ़ाना अभी के लिए आपके लिए बेनिफिशियल नहीं होगा. आपके लिए बेनिफिशियल क्या होगा, जो काम की चीज़ है बस उस पर फोकस करना, और काम की चीज़ फॉर्मूला है या फिर थ्योरेटिकल पोर्शन के कुछ की पॉइंट्स हैं जो मैंने आपको डिस्क्राइब किया. बट यस, डेफिनेटली नेक्स्ट जो हमारा लॉन्ग टर्म प्लान होगा उसके अंदर हम किसी भी टॉपिक को अगर मैं पिक करूंगा तो उस टॉपिक को हम पूरे डिटेल से डिस्कशन करेंगे, तब आपको भी मजा आएगा और वो चीज़ मुझे भी मजा आएगा. राइट, वापस से बता दूं, राडार की क्लास, राडार वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द राडार. ओनली वन क्लास इज सफिशियंट फॉर द राडार. 45 मिनट्स टू वन आवर की क्लास होगी फॉर द राडार, और आई थिंक दैट इज सफिशियंट फॉर द इसरो एग्जाम. आप इसरो एग्जाम के लिए आपका सफिशियंट होगा. राइट, टिल दैट थैंक यू वेरी मच. राइट, ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट.